Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today, I haven't done this in a while, let me take you on a little tour of Clincheck 6.0 and some of my favorite buttons and kind of how I review a case. So I do have permission to show this case. I do not have permission to show you the photos of this case, but I will show you how to use the dashboard and kind of when I get a case, what I do. So the first thing I do if I'm not familiar with the patient is I'm going to go up to the recs button at the top up here, and I'm going to click through the records, the patient records. You're going to see that you should see a full set of photos, as well as hopefully you've uploaded a panoramic x-ray and a cephalometric x-ray if needed. Next thing I do is the very first thing is I'm going to go ahead and hit the maxill button right here. I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to check, push the occluse button, which hopefully has a green dot. And I'm going to make sure the contacts are the way that I saw them either at the refinement or when I took the new set of records. This is totally critical. You want to be using simple, double-sided articulating paper on every single patient, every single time you take clinical photos, every single time you do a new case, every single time you do a refinement. I don't care, because 50% of the time this gets mounted wrong, and it is, I don't know if it's an error with your scanner. I don't know if it's an error with just the whole process. It just happens, and it will guaranteed make your ClinCheck not predictable. And this is like number one, my top three things. It's just such an easy fix. Tap, tap, grind, grind, get the contacts. I want to see it matching. So if this is what it said, this is what I expect. Now, this is not unusual for a refinement. This is a refinement. But for a new patient, this would be unusual unless they had some existing retainer. And if so, I might have them stop wearing the retainer for a little while and let the bite settle before I started, because this is gonna be a lot more complicated. So always, always verify this clinically. Easy step to make things more predictable. All right, and you do the same thing at the end. When you finish the case, you wanna see it, now you wanna see it nice and even, posterior contacts, multiple points of contacts, at least on molars. I know we're probably gonna have another refinement here, so I wasn't worried about the sevens because they're not fully in. Premolars, maybe canine guidance, we'll worry about that later. But no anterior contacts at the end. Okay, so that's the first thing I do, initial and final articulation. Beyond that, then I'm gonna go ahead and look at the movements, okay? And I'm gonna see if I like the way things are moving. Usually I do a quick play from the front. Now this one has already been intentionally slowed down. I'll usually double my trays once I get my movements that I want, but I wait till the end. I think you guys know that. So, and then I do the same thing from the other buttons. If this is a new case, always a good idea to push that Bolton button. I'm not able to show you the Bolton tap table just because it does have some personal information on it, but I'd like to know if we have mandibular excess or a Bolton discrepancy that is mandibular or maxillary in nature. If you're not sure what that means, go to my YouTube channel, type in the keyword Bolton, or you can go into my blog channel and type in the keyword Bolton and read all about how to deal with Boltons and what this means. Obviously, this patient does have mandibular Bolton because we have a pig lateral, and even this guy would have been pig as well. He was pig, but this patient had this tooth extracted because there was a bony defect that occurred due to some trauma, and there was also an impacted canine, all of which was done with Invisalign, so be impressed. You can do all kind of hard cases. If anybody tells you you can't, that is not true. The smile button, I'm not gonna push it right now just because, again, I don't have permission to show the photos, just the ClinCheck, but it will actually show you the patients. If you use the photo upload or the practice app, and if you use an iTero scanner, you'll be able to see the patient's midline in real time. This is very, very powerful. As well as if you've enabled Smile Architect, which I don't think we have on this one because this is an older case. It's a great way to be able to see restorative, to see what it looks like. But those are the main things that I really like to use, as well as the roots feature. If you are using a CBCT and you're uploading that, that is so powerful. Definitely want to be doing this. If you have a CBCT, 100% get it set up. It is going to help you from making a lot of mistakes. It's going to help make your ClinChecks more predictable, go quicker. You're going to be less likely to be pushing teeth through the bone. You're going to know if you can expand. You're going to know if you can procline. It's really, really helpful. So I'd strongly recommend that. But those are just some of my favorite tools that are on the ClinCheck and some of the things I do on every case. Hopefully that is helpful. And don't forget, anytime you see a blue or black dot, extrusion, intrusion, extrusion, extrusion, you want to put attachments on anything with a blue or black dot. That is at least rotation, extrusion. Intrusion, I'm not too worried about. Yes, we will need to put some attachments on these eventually. All right, hopefully that was helpful. Thank you.